available as long as he was registered as a student, assuming that this endowment can see him through his education thereafter. The provision was that the remainder would go to a charity. When Dr. Lee returned about 20 years later, he was still the resident student there. And he found from his inquiry sometime after that that he remained a student on campus until his death. He took every course in the cabin, many of them more than once. He studied continually. He knew a prodigious lot, as Dr. Lee said. And he described him, perhaps uncharitably, as being something of a useless academic freak. He never made one contribution to society. His whole effort was selfish. He never really prepared himself. And then the concluding estimate was, he could not. All of his years in an educational institution and all of the courses he had passed could not describe him as an educated person. I congratulate you, our students here at this college, because of a very useful and practical and important nature of the offerings here. You should be very grateful that there is such a school. Mention was made that our son is in vocational education. Very grateful for that. Our oldest son on one occasion was launched out in a very theoretical field. He seemed very competent in pursuing that field, and I remember well one night when we sat down and I said, son, if you finish your schooling, you have much of your hill that lived in your hands. Making the capital contribution. He pondered on that, changed his course, re-registered, changed his pattern of education. In order that, besides something in his head, he might have something in his hand. I think of the incident where a man was very interested in the competent gardener. He bought a home. In the course of the season, it finally developed a yard, and the garden was beautiful. Flowers on the borders, ducklings, vegetable garden, fruit trees producing. And the minister stopped by, and after surveying, the minister said, "My, this is a wonderful thing the Lord has done for you." His answer was, "Yes. You should have seen this plot of ground when he had it all to himself." We're very conscious that in order to build things, you have to know how to build them. You have to be able to build things, and somebody eventually has to. That's true in communities, it's true in nations, it's true in churches. So I think all of us as citizens can be very grateful for what goes on in this school. I've been scratching in the depths of my mind to a few lines of verse that I have returned to for so many years, and I miss more than I have been traveling to be excused as a messenger. Today, a professor in a garden relaxed, like Plato of old in the Academy showed, spoke out in a manner I never had heard yet. These are some of the things that he said. Suppose that we say, as a tenet of wisdom, that knowledge is not for the light of the mind, but an end of itself, the packet of treasure to hold and employ for the good of mankind. For knowledge itself is barren of meaning, except to give life to men. Species and tones and accept their tools in the building of time. We scholars toil on with the zeal of a mind, the methods, one method more. The scholars will need to study the uses, all the vast masses of the data and world. For truly our endless and tireless researches, deep linking of man's daily problems and strife, for beauty and truth and virtue and value, depending on their uses in practical life. I think we should be grateful for this building, this school, which links in practical life all that's important. And I'm sure this building will make a good contribution. And grateful likewise that we are in that community where we feel not only important but important to have the prayer for the community, the wonderful lessons of the Lord, and then to offer dedicatory prayer in which we invoke the blessings and the watch care for the Almighty and all that goes on in the building. So if you will join me, I will represent the administration and announce the dedicatory prayer on this college seat. Our heavenly and eternal Father, we are grateful to be assembled here in this world. This great education institution, assembled, rejoicing over the creation of the world, to the use of the training of the world. And we are grateful to our Heavenly Father to acknowledge the day that we are interested in the kingdom. And we are interested in the kingdom, that we are concerned about the kingdom. We are concerned about the world. We are concerned about the world. We are particularly grateful this day to our Heavenly Father and those who have worked in the administration of the school, those who serve as faculty members, those who come as students. Each class as it comes forward, making a contribution, which now has been accumulated momentarily into making this meeting possible. We pray that those who have made these contributions share part of the lesson that comes to our person who will use this building in the years to come. We pray at once for the nation, for the people of the nation, for the leaders of the world. The purposes of this building might be fulfilled over the generations ahead. And we ask that you will grant protection from this campus, from this building, to the end that it might be needed for the purposes for which it has been erected. Students and faculty members and guests are going to go from this building. There might be a spirit here of usefulness and pride, wisdom, and joy, relaxation, all the purposes of the building might be. We are grateful that God has blessed mankind with the ability to connect and to decide to obey buildings such as this. We are grateful that in the world, when so many material resources are being devoted to causes that are unworthy and corrupt, that we can know